On April 21st, 2016, the Balloon Engineering and Research Squad from the Josiah Bartlett School in Bartlett, New Hampshire, got up at 2 a.m., met at the school at 3 a.m., and drove an hour northwest to launch a high-altitude balloon to the edge of space from the Maplewood Golf Course in Bethlehem, New Hampshire. The launch was part of the Global Space Balloon Challenge and was scheduled for 4:45 a.m. to capture the full moonset and the sunrise over the Atlantic Ocean. We had a few delays, but at 5:14 a.m., we launched, and the chase began. Lights all over the place, but here is the inflation being done right here. Who's that doing the inflation? Haley! There's Bruce doing the heavy looking on, making sure everything's happening right. And we have people holding the nets up all over the place. And Justin, our main monkey climber guy and tracker.
Tell them what the net's for, Roger.
The net is so the balloon doesn't float away and we can measure the neck lift on it without touching it. Okay, Justin and Cheyenne, come down through here. So Cheyenne, all this stuff we can see. Okay, here's our parachute. And then we're going down, and this is our radar reflector. And down here is our buckyball. And down here is Caleb standing guard at the payload capsule, which we haven't started putting together yet. And down here, get run down here, everybody follow me. There's a light so nobody accidentally steps on this, but way down here is Dragonfly Darter, which is going to fly up and do pictures from above. And over here is our handy-dandy tracking antenna and our monitor and receiver. And this is the end of this broadcast, and we will catch you after lunch.
No. Okay, I just got to go through it. So that one is going. We are recording telemetry. We got telemetry rolling. That is going. Get confirmation on that. We've got this one that's supposed to kick in, but it hasn't yet. We may have to go back to this, so keep that in mind. Mm-hmm. And let's hook up and everything else. Okay, this is our video transmitter. Video transmitter is going and it's on channel 9. Okay, hook up the other stuff here. Okay, strobe light is going.
Yep, okay, we'll see that.
Oh, that's, it was this right here. The one I couldn't find if I dropped the bag outside. That's what I wanted to do. I didn't want it to fall on top of the transmitter.
Yeah.
What did I do with that red piece of tape I cut off, though? Or did I not cut it off?
I think you just crumpled it off. Well, it's been 5 minutes now.
Yeah, so we're...
That's good for us to know, though.
And the camera did not start taking pictures. We're going to take that apart. Is it 4:50? Let me see if I can check this thing. Okay, so it might be starting in a couple of seconds. Just tell me if you hear it start.
Okay.
If you hear it taking pictures. You heard it taking pictures? Yep, you're right. It is. Bruce, how are we doing? Oh, the sky is
lighting
up already.
How'd you make it out, Robert?
I'm ready to go. Just gotta seal it up and we're ready to go.
Okay, what about the little button thing over there?
Yeah, you gotta do that. Thank you for reminding me. You gotta shut it down and do that. Good man. Okay. Okay, Caleb, get down here and I'm gonna tell you to put your finger on that button, hold it down, tell me you've
right
got
now?
It. Yep, do you feel it click? Is it clicking? Or did it click?
Well, yeah, it did.
Yeah, make sure it clicked. So it clicked?
Yeah.
Okay. Watcher double blink?
Yep.
Sweet, we got it. So glad you reminded me of that. Okay, and that will be rolling, and that will be rolling.
Holt, stay right here, because put this in the bag and put this in your pocket again. I've got to strap the helicopter in the bag.
Okay. Yeah. Wait, which one? This canister? Like this? Whoops. Right. It opened a bit. Like this? Oh, wow.
Do you have a coyote?
Yeah, I do. That's really cool. Can I put it down now?
Yep, put it down. All right. I just want to make sure it's functioning everything.
Awesome.
It seems to be functioning, so.
Okay,
we got this. Okay, let's.
One more look. Look, you got that tape in your pocket?
Yep, I do.
Okay, everything is.
You need tape?
Yep.
Come right down here with me so we can start and wrap around it.
Just. Oh, should I grab the scissors?
Yep. Keep this as, just put them down there.
Okay.
Keep this as centered as you can, starting right here with one around it to tape it. So just put it like halfway, you know, so it's like, leave it like a quarter of an inch down to the top edge, okay? So I'm gonna go around and you just go around behind me and take your hands and press against it so it's warm and hold it in place, you know?
Okay.
Like, get right down on the ground. Take your hands and go. Take one of these and go around it, warm them up, you know, put them right on the thing, and warm it, and then press it in with your hands, so it sticks. It's not sticking with the band.
Yeah.
Like, warm it, and then take it with your fingers and push it right in. Okay. Can't get any more? Okay. Okay, we get it. So keep that and go. Caleb, we gotta put up wrap up the antennas. Can you come help us now? Hold it. You gotta hold it.
Hold the antenna?
Yeah, we gotta put the antenna. Yeah, we gotta wrap it with tape. But we need to have you hold it off the ground. I just make this phone call and then.
Yes, I can do that. I get to let it go.
We're getting ready to launch. We're way behind schedule, obviously, so. Okay. All right. I'm going to hang up on you now. I just wanted to tell you. Because can you see us, though? Are you seeing the tracker?
I have not. No, I don't see the tracker yet.
Okay.
That's what I'm just looking at.
Yeah.
You guys
I have no idea, so we're just hoping that it's going, and I didn't even look to see it blinking, to tell you the truth, I should have, but anyway, I got to hang up because we were having trouble inflating, the helium froze up on us or whatever, so I will. I'm going to talk to you later.
Keep me posted.
All right. Caleb, hold on to this because I got to push up on it. Get down here, go.
Like that?
Yeah. Do not set it down.
Just holding this.
Yeah, hold on. Caleb! What? Come back here and spell her holding this thing.
What?
Never heard the word spell somebody?
Spell?
Hold this. Spell her. You know, you're gonna hold it for her so she's not holding it. Hold it by the knot right where she's holding it. Give me a chance to check all those rules too. So. Do not set it down. The antenna will hit the ground.
Yeah. I don't think that's a good thing. You want me to take
what, you're shaking out of control?
I'll take it.
I like
you.
I'll take it.
I got it. Hey guys, look at
that. No. I got it. Jake, it has to be.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
It has to be level. You gotta. Just let me take it.
I won't.
With other materials attached to it.
No, it's not.
Right. You want to let the string go up gently, so you're just holding it by the payload box.
Okay.
Right now.
Ready? Let yours up gently.
Okay.
Ready, 10. Never mind, there it goes.
Thank you. Okay, if you can hear me out there, good morning. This is the balloon tracking station glide in Bartlett, New Hampshire. Sorry for the delay here, but we've had some technical difficulties getting the balloon up and waiting for the telemetry to come in. We will be making adjustments as it goes along. As you can see, it's been in the air for approximately 17 minutes now. As I said, the signal will come and go as we make adjustments on the antenna. You can actually see some live video coming from the balloon. You can see the telemetry on there. The coordinates are on the top. Oh, there we go. There we go. Wowza. The balloon. See it. Check it out now. Now we're coming up here.
Getting a little lighter.
We're picking up some video.
Little thing spin.
We are getting GPS coordinates on it. Oh yeah, that's just the. This is the bottom of the box you're seeing on them. Yeah. It's on a long tether, and all it does is spin around and around and around. Okay, and Roger wanted me to explain to anyone listening out there that the AT&T apparently didn't have a signal up there, so we're not doing the Flytrex at the moment. It just hasn't acquired a signal on a cell tower, so this is it for the moment. And I believe that they should be coming down through Crawford Notch while they're tracking this thing. Oh, that's pretty neat. From a scientific standpoint.
I think you're wasting your talents as a mechanic.
Absolutely, I should be doing this for a living.
WKRP.
Okay, yeah, we've got good focus on the screen.
You see the horizon now. It just showed over on the left-hand side.
Yep. It's hard to tell what you're looking down on.
That's the mountains right there.
That right there up in the left-hand corner was, I believe, probably Bretton Woods ski area.
Well, that's what I'm wondering. Those mountains right there, without a map quick in our hands, I'm wondering if that's the Rosebud Range.
I don't know. It's hard to tell when it's spinning around. So
you get dizzy watching it, but it's...
Yeah, there it is right there. That is probably Bretton Woods. Because it's looking straight down on that. Let me make an adjustment here on my signal. Makes me woozy watching it.
This needs to be a warm summer morning with the bugs thick. Really?
Oh, at this point, that should be.
How's that?
What's that?
Yeah,
something up there.
Straight up.
Oh, what is that?
That's not a star.
I
don't believe there's no other stars around. We're light enough we wouldn't see a star. That's it.
Is that it?
I'll bet you.
You can see it?
Yeah.
Hold on, folks.
Are you really?
We may have a visual here. Let's,
It sure is. Jim, you want to take a look?
But I'm not getting a...
That thing's snuck.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, that thing snuck right up on us.
I'll be darned. Okay, folks, wave.
That's neat looking.
Oh, yeah, that's looking... Okay, I can see...
You definitely see it's a balloon.
Hang on, we're going to make some quick adjustments here.
Yeah. It's looking directly down.
Jim Pettengill and the ground tracking crew, while doing a live stream broadcast, spotted the balloon with a naked eye at 51,938 feet above sea level and were able to watch it until it burst at 81,741 feet. An independent viewer 11 miles away as the crow flies in Conway, New Hampshire, also spotted it and watched it through his binoculars as it burst. We arrived in Bartlett at the tracking station minutes after the balloon was spotted in the sky, and we were able to look up at the star we had put there an hour earlier.